Hi, I'm Pastor Will Nichols, and I want to share something with you about two things that you have to have before you really need it. And before I do that, let me just tell you a little bit about my journey. I've been pastoring for 23 years, just celebrated my 23rd anniversary. And I learned something through in this journey that for the first 20 years, I had an approach that God had to disabuse me of. And that approach was to get as many butts in the pews as possible, to get as many people to join my church as possible. And God disabused me of that by saying these simple words, Will, I didn't call you to get people to sign up for your church. I called you to shepherd my sheep. It wasn't about growing the number of people that go to our church, but growing the sheep that God, growing the people that God had sent to me. And he showed me exactly how to do that. And we shifted our ministry from being all things to all people to get as many people as we can to focusing on a core group of people who wanted to grow. And God showed me how through what we call sermon-based growth groups. These sermon-based growth groups give us two things. Remember I talked about two things earlier? You know, when you have a kitchen fire, you don't need to go looking for a fire extinguisher. You get to already have one. When you're on the side of the road on 40 with a flat tire, you can't go trying to shop for a spare tire. You get to already have one. And when it comes to life, the perils of life, the challenges of life, going through a bad marriage, struggling at your finances, ethical matters, just life kicking you behind, you got to have these two things already on lock. The first one is a deep abiding relationship with God based upon his word, not based upon how you feel, not based upon how you dance, but based upon what God said. And the second thing you must have is a strong relationship with Christ-centered individuals based upon that same premise. God gave us two commandments: love him with everything that we got and love our neighbor as ourselves. When God disabused me of trying to get more members and say, focus on the one that I sent you, he showed me growth groups. And he said, teach my people how to fall in love with me through my word and teach them to connect with each other. Because when you're in a fight, you got to know what God said. And you got to have somebody that's going to back you up, pick you up, and warm you up. And that's what we do through our growth groups. We got testimonials of people whose lives have just been changed as a result of participating in our growth groups.
I came here about 13 and a half years ago from Maryland. One of my coworkers told me, you need to come to this church. So my mom always said, you need to be into a Bible-based church. So I came to the church and I've been coming here for years. And I had never, in all that time, connected with anybody. I hadn't talked to anybody. I would come in and out, I would dip in, dip out, come to Bible study, dip in, pop out, but I never really talked to anybody, connected to anybody. I was even contemplating leaving the church. That's how bad it got for me. Until one night, back in January, in December, I came to Bible study, and they were doing growth groups, and I was like, what is this? So I sat in a growth group for singles, and it just changed my life. The pastor would teach us in church on Sunday, we can get to talk about it more closely and more in depth in the growth groups, and I'm really learning. My relationship with God has changed. I've gotten closer to him. I've gotten closer to people here at church. They know me, they hug me when they see me, they miss me. And it's like, it just changed. I'm telling you, this has changed my life. If you haven't tried it, you need to try it. If other churches are not doing it, they need to do it, because you never know what somebody's going through on the inside as a member. For me, it just changed me. God just gave that idea to him for me. It just touched my heart. I just love everybody. It's just, I'm telling you, you need to join a group and get involved, because it'll change your life. It really will. It changed mine.
groups. And I want to challenge you to do the same by going to victoryspraise.org/connect. I want you to learn about our different groups, our groups for our children and our teenagers and our college students, our groups for those that are new to the community and new to the church, group for singles and married, for empty nesters, for millennials, for even people who are just enthusiasts in various areas such as motorcycles and cars. We have something for everyone. It allows you to connect with people just like yourself to foster community. And that's what's significant. Not community around gossip, but community around God's word. People who are transparent so that God's word can truly come to pass. We that are strong bear the infirmities of the weak. Scriptures that say, confess your faults one to another, pray for one another that you may be healed. The effectual fervent prayer of the righteous availeth much. And so where two or three are gathered together, I will be there in the midst of them. This is what we are able to accomplish through sermon-based growth groups at Victorious Praise. And I encourage you simply to go to victoriouspraise.org/connect, not to join the church, but to connect with other people and with God's word. I trust that you will join us as we start our new set of growth groups. We're going to have a lot of fun. We're going to connect with God, and we're going to connect with each other. God bless you.